Hi, I'm Wilbur Pan. I put out a call for questions on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram a while back about Japanese tools, and I'm going to cover some of them now. I got some questions about how can I incorporate Japanese saws with Western saws, and about proper and efficient body mechanics, as Shannon Rogers mentions, when using Western saws, and could I elaborate that on that with Japanese saws? So, although I think that using Japanese tools in a Western workshop is completely feasible, the one thing I would not do is try to mix up Japanese saws with Western saws. The mechanics of using a Western saw and a Japanese saw are different enough that I think it'll just be confusing in the long run if you're switching back and forth between the two. So if you're already good with a Western saw, there's really no reason to switch to Japanese saws. But if you're a beginner with hand saws, or if you are trying out Western saws and having troubles with it, then Japanese saws might be the thing for you. In terms of body mechanics, it's pretty much the same as in using Western saws. What you want to do when using a saw is just keep the saw moving back and forth, try not to put any downward pressure on the saw when making the cut, and letting the saw do the work as you go through the cut. You can use a Japanese saw one-handed, or you can center your body on the cut and use it two-handed as well, which actually fixes a lot of problems in terms of the cut veering off to the left and the right as you use it. One of the questions that came in was asking about proper care for Japanese tools to take full advantage of them, other than the obvious issues with sharpening. The answer to that is you need to take care of your Japanese tools more or less the same way that you would take care of any other hand tool. Rust is an issue. Luckily, my basement workshop is pretty free from rust-like conditions because the air is pretty well conditioned in there. But if your workshop isn't conditioned, or if you have a routine problem with rust on hand tools, whatever you're using to prevent rust on your hand tools can be used with Japanese tools. Traditionally, they would use camellia oil to coat the tool to try to prevent rust, but you can pretty much use anything that you want. Can you tell me, as a newbie, on the 10 or however many essential Japanese tools? Well, this depends a lot on the type of work that you do, but for the most part, these are good places to start. If you're interested in getting a Japanese chisel, just start off with one. Japanese chisels work really well, but they do tend to be shorter than Western chisels, and some people may like the shorter length, other people may prefer the longer length. So I would get one in the size that you would use a lot, like a quarter inch or a half an inch or 3/8 of an inch. Use it for a while, and if you like it, buy some more. In terms of Japanese saws, there are 4 Japanese saws that you can buy as a good starter kit if you want to go all in all at once. That would include a Ryoba that's made by Gyokucho, a rip and a crosscut Dazuki, and some sort of larger Japanese saw in order to make bigger cuts. That's a good starting point. The total cost of those saws is probably somewhere around $225 to $250 or so at today's prices. As far as Japanese planes go, I don't think that anyone has to use Japanese planes. I think they're a lot of fun to use, but if you were to start with just one, just get a standard Japanese smoothing plane and see how it works for you. There is a little bit of a learning curve in terms of getting used to a Japanese plane, but I don't think it's as steep or as difficult as you might believe. One of the questions that came in was about sharpening. And the question was, should beginners take the plunge into synthetic stones over the sandpaper setup? I assume you're talking about the scary sharp method where you have sandpaper on a piece of glass. Overall, I would go with water stones for several reasons. Number one, Japanese tool steels are very hard, and you need a fairly aggressive sharpening medium to be able to sharpen them efficiently. It's not impossible to use, say, oil stones to sharpen Japanese tools, but you're going to spend a longer time doing it. I found that water stones is probably the best option. Diamond stones cut pretty fast, but I find that diamond stones give me this fingers on the blackboard feeling that just drives me nuts, and so that's why I don't use them. In terms of using sandpaper, for the times I've needed to grind out a nick, getting a piece of 80 grit sandpaper on a piece of glass was probably one of the fastest ways that I had of doing that. But over the long haul, I can pretty much promise you that you're going to get tired of buying more sandpaper and replacing it every time it wears out, because the stuff wears out pretty quickly when you're talking about using them on Japanese tool steels. So to that end, I would go ahead and get the water stones. Oftentimes I'm asked about what's the most economic approach. And to my mind, if you're into hand tools of any sort, your sharpening method is going to be something you're going to use every single time you're in your shop. And to that end, it's worth laying out the money up front for a tool that you're going to use literally every time you do woodworking. Over the long haul, it'll be more than worth it. Hope that helps.